This video is about MAPS. MAPS stands for Modeling Applied to Problem Solving, and that's the pedagogy that we're going to be using in this course. Now, pedagogies don't just fall out of the sky. They're designed for some purpose. And fundamentally, those considerations start with what we want you to learn. And so what is it that we want you to learn? I think basically, in one word, it's summed up in expertise. We want you to become an expert and to think about problems in mechanics like an expert and to solve them like an expert. Now, I've said solve problems, not get the answer. And that's a big, important distinction. Probably in high school or wherever you learned physics before, you concentrated on finding the formula and getting the answer. To become more expert-like, you have to think, how do you approach the problem? You need to have a systematic approach, and you need to be able to plan a solution. And finally, once you've gotten the solution done and you have an answer, you have to, and this is very important, you have to check whether your answer is sensible. And these are important things, especially this latter, because all of these skills, the skill to be systematic about how you solve problems, the skill to analyze whether the answer makes any sense at all, are important in other courses, they're important in life. Besides thinking like an expert in your approach to problems, I'd like you to think, as most experts do, that what this subject is and how it works is really elegant. It's really beautiful on some level. The idea that you can take just a few axioms, basically F equals MA, take some mathematics and extend that, and then find that over a wide range of physical problems, you can get a precise answer, an answer that's good to a part in 100,000, that's really, really accurate. That's really pretty amazing. And on top of that, what you find in this process of extending F equals MA systematically is that new concepts like angular momentum or linear momentum or energy emerge. And these concepts can be incredibly important. I might point out that you pay for energy in our society, but you don't pay for force. Now, let's get to modeling applied to problem solving itself. What is this method all about? There's basically two components, two legs upon which this thing stands. The first thing is we're going to give you a systematic way to model problems, to approach new problems and figure out how to solve them. The second feature is that when you're solving them, you will use a hierarchy of models. You will have arranged your existing knowledge in a form where it's easy to figure out which of it you want to apply to the problem. So in this hierarchy, you will classify energy and momentum and dynamics and angular momentum and energy all in a very uniform way that shows the similarities and the difference between these different core concepts, and which enables you to have easy access in modeling these things. Now, the systematic way for modeling new problems involves fundamentally, and right at the beginning, our procedure, which you'll hear an awful lot of, called systems, interactions, and models. And that helps you represent the problem in a way that you can decompose it and apply the core models. We also want you to learn whether the answer is sensible, whether it's reasonable, and finally, when you've gotten the answer, we want you to learn to suppress your normal tendency to rush on to the next problem and to back up and just think retrospectively, what did I learn when I solved this problem? How did I organize the knowledge that I already had to deal with this unfamiliar situation? What was my plan for getting through to the solution?